Hi, I'm Billy Beck, Extension Forestry Specialist with Iowa State University Extension and Outreach, and I'm standing in one of my all-time favorite Iowa forest types, and that's the Bottomland Forest. These are the forests that border our rivers and streams in the state. They occupy low topographic areas of the landscape, and they're just an absolutely incredible resource. Personally, me, I love the fact that they're just so deeply connected with the rivers that they border. They influence those rivers, and the rivers influence them. So it's just really fascinating a spot on the landscape. And if you look at the numbers, Iowa's got about 8% total forest coverage as far as land cover. But over 30% of our rivers and streams are bordered by forest. So if you do the math, it's really neat, and it kind of suggests that, you know, Iowa is a riparian forest state. And if you look around me here, you see a lot of species that are really characteristic of these floodplain forest communities. And they're really cool because they change as you move from the channel, and even as you bump up a little bit in elevation, you're going to see a different species assemblage. So right near the channel, we see a lot of heavy flood tolerant species like black willow. And as you move away a little bit and you get out onto the active floodplain, the area that floods historically every 1 to 3 years, you see species like sycamore, silver maple, cottonwood, a box elder. As you get even further out and the elevation gets up a little bit, we call that the second bench. This is a little bit better drained, and you start seeing species like black walnut, bur oak, hackberry, and things like that. Those areas are not very flooded very frequently, and they're a little bit better drainage. So you see a different species composition based on where you are in these floodplains. And all these floodplain forest species are incredibly adapted to what I'll call this very volatile environment. And when I talk about volatility, I'm talking about flooding. Flooding is the big disturbance here. It keeps that successional clock kicked back, and it allows for these early successional sun-loving species to really persist on the landscape. So flooding really brings you a great number of things, but if you think about it, it gives you standing water, you know, at periods of the year. So that means low soil oxygen. The species out here can really persist, and their roots can function effectively in those zones of low oxygen with standing water. Another thing floods bring is actual physical damage to trees. Especially in the spring, you get a lot of heavy flows, you get ice debris, you get wood debris barreling down here. And these trees respond to that by being very quick growing. They're very rapid growing species, so if they do get damaged, they can rebound very quickly and get their heads above that level of the next incoming flood. So they can persist here kind of with that flooding interval. The last thing, and this is almost critical, it is critical for for these species to persist on the landscape, is heavy siltation. So after floods recede, we get a nice new layer of silt and sediment on the floodplain. And then historically in spring, what would happen is that flood water recedes and trees like silver maple and cottonwood release their windborne seeds that coat that brand new sediment deposit layer and take full advantage of the abundant sunlight. And they just carpet the area, they take it over, and they just grow rapidly in that new full sun. So again, that flooding and that heavy siltation is a disturbance that helps keep these sun-loving species on the landscape. And even the older trees, when we get that heavy silt deposits, their roots can either expand or do nicely in that low oxygen kind of newly buried situation. So really cool adaptations for the trees that are found in these areas. And just all kinds of benefits to all Iowans that come from these forests. And an obvious one is water quality and flooding. So if you can picture a massive amount of water rushing through this floodplain, these rigid upright stems really act to stop and slow down that flood pulse. And that has big implications for downstream flooding, really minimizes that flood pulse from going downstream. That slow velocity too allows sediment, and a lot of times phosphorus attached to that sediment, to drop out and enter long-term storage in the floodplain. Another really great thing that they do is they shade and cool our streams, which increases dissolved oxygen. And finally, when the waters recede and you get these little depressional areas that have now filled up with silt and organic matter like oxbows and little depressions, those are great places for denitrification to occur. So nitrate removal from our surface waters as well. Wildlife. There is all kinds of wildlife benefits, and they use these floodplain forests extensively. But two overlooked things with wildlife, I think the first one is the wood. These trees are fast growing, they're weak wooded, They break, and they contribute a lot of woody material to the floodplain and in the channel. That is incredible habitat and substrate for aquatic biota in our rivers and streams. And another thing too, when they get in there, when that woody debris gets in the channel, they cause all kind of eddies and velocity differences that cause scour pools and meanders, you know, all kinds of great fish habitat. And the second thing, which I think is very overlooked, is pollinator, the pollinator contribution of riparian and streamside and floodplain forests. Nobody really thinks about that when they think about floodplain forests. But one really cool example is willow. Willow is one of the first things to bloom in the spring. It doesn't have showy flowers, so nobody notices it. But next spring, check out your willows and you'll see a buzz of pollinators around them. And that's critical early fuel for recently emerging insects in the spring. Lastly, and this kind of goes on a lot of people's radar already, but is timber value. So these are incredibly fertile, incredibly productive timber sites. Just two examples. On our first bench, our active floodplain area, we've got silver maple, a surprisingly valuable timber species, especially along our big rivers. And then as you get up into that secondary second bench, well-drained soil, of course you've got black walnut, the number one timber value species in our state. So again, I am absolutely in love with these areas. They're just so deeply connected to the river channels next to them. They influence the river, but the river also influences them. They've got incredible benefits to all Iowans: water quality, flooding, wildlife, timber value, everything you can imagine. And lastly, those benefits are so disproportionate to the narrow kind of margin that they occupy in the landscape. So floodplain forests, I love them.